Hello fellow makers, and welcome to this brand new episode of Freddy's Customs. Today I am making Thrall, an orc character from World of Warcraft game. This is actually the second one I am making. This one though is a very different model. So without further ado, let's get to it. As a base skin color, I premixed bright yellowish green. After that, I dry brushed a bit of gray blue and started applying layers of washes. I use greens, browns, yellows, and even a bit of red. This way, I wanted to achieve a lot of irregularities on the skin so it acts realistic. Basically, this whole model is about washes. Lots of layers of different washes everywhere. You can see same techniques here on the head. Some dry brushing to create highlighted spots and then washes plus dry pastels. If you are curious about the eyes, feel free to check out my tutorial about skin and eyes where I painted head sculpt of Tony Stark. And if you'd like to know what kind of washes I use, I have a bunch of Vallejo washes from Vallejo Weathering series. Orange, black, gray, brown. Also, I like to use various Citadel's contrast paints. These are all transparent paints, but I also mix washes from regular paint, just diluting it a lot to water consistency. There is a lot of fur on this model, so I decided to elevate this statue a bit and cut off all of the fur parts and replace it with the real one. It was quite a messy job, but eventually worth the effort. By the way, this is a fake fur that I was able to buy locally. Here I just do some finishing touches with gloss varnish on the eggs and moving on to the next part. I guess I spent most of the time on the hammer, as I couldn't get it where I wanted to be for quite some time, since I was experimenting with the washes and techniques on whole model. What you see on the video is still not the final state of it, as I worked a lot on it later when I was not recording. Thank you. Here again I am creating some diversity on the leather parts by applying different washes, mostly browns and oranges. I also use dry pastels. It might seem I overdo here, but you kill most of it by using varnish to seal it. Which is very important thing, by the way. I was using mud varnish a lot to seal my paint between layers when I didn't want to next wash destroy my previous effect. I also added some pins on the belt that is this model missing. For that, I just use UV sensitive resin from my printer. Eventually, this model took me about 40 hours of work. That's how much footage I recorded and cut it down to about 20 minutes. I gotta say, I really enjoy of creating these leather effects, and it's a nice change from all of these superhero stuff characters. I hope I would be able to do more Warcraft statues in the future. Also, I think this nice model deserves custom base, so I decided to create diorama-like base with LEDs. Video of me making it will be released as a second part later. that, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video as I enjoyed making it. Thank you for watching and keep on making.